The essential question in Chapter 10 is, how are statistics used to draw inferences about and compare populations? In Lesson 10.1, you're going to be looking at the measures of center, and you might also recognize this as the measures of central tendency. For your I can statements, I can use the mean, median, and mode as measures of center, and I can choose an appropriate measure of center and recognize measures of statistics. In the middle of the page, you have your definitions of mean, median, and mode. Just remember to familiarize yourself with those definitions. And then the vocabulary words you have to write down are statistics, the study of collecting, organizing, and interpreting information or data, and then measures of center. So mean, median, and mode are called measures of center, or you might also know them as measures of central tendency. In example one, it just says to find the mean, median, and mode of the data. Look through that and remember how to calculate each of those measures. At the bottom of page 434, the got it problem that I want you to write down on your note sheet. I've done some pre-work here for the mean. I've already added up all the numbers. It totals 600. And then there are 12 data points. So 600 divided by 12 is equal to 50. So the mean of the data is 50. The median is when you line up all the numbers in order from least to greatest. And then the two middle numbers, in this case, there's two middle numbers, so we're going to find the average of those two. The number between 48 and 50 is 49, so the median is 49. And lastly, the mode is the one that occurs the most often, and it looks like there are three different times that 48 appears, so the mode is 48. Please write those items down on your note sheet. At the top of page 435, we're looking at example two. The table shows the water usage of a household during the same 8 months for 2 years, and it says to compare the mean and the median usage. And so for this problem, we're going to calculate the mean and the median for both pieces of data, and then we're going to compare them. So for example two, on page 435, we have the Fitzgeralds and the Corduroys, and I've already lined up all of their ages over here on the left. So I've put them in order from least to greatest so that I can find the median. And I've circled the median age for the Fitzgeralds and the median age for the Corderos. Okay. In the Fitzgeralds case, we're going to divide by 5 because there's 5 ages, whereas the Corderos' ages, there are 7. So I'm going to divide by 7. So what you need to do is go ahead and list that the Cordero family's median is 9, and then the mean is 25. The Fitzgeralds' mean is 31.4, and their median is 22. So in both cases, the Corderos are younger based on their mean and their median. At the bottom of page 435, you have a very informative concept summary chart on when to use each one of the measures of center. So mean is when the data has no extreme values. That means all the data points are very close to one another, and there are not any values that are much greater or much less than the rest of the data. Use the median when the data have extreme values or there are no big gaps in the middle of the data. In mode, the data have many repeated numbers. So this is a very useful chart for you to keep in mind when trying to find the best measure of center. On page 436, we have example 3, and it's asking us to take a look at the data of the number of sit-ups and then choose the best measure of center. If you're looking at example 3, there is this value, 19, that kind of doesn't match the rest of them. So there's that extreme value that we kind of don't want to pay attention to that might throw off the mean. So in this case, I think the median is the best case because there is that extreme value in there. So 45 would be the answer, and so would the word median. Okay, median and then 45 would be the answer. At the bottom of page 436, it says to find the mean and the median, and then which one would be the better one to report. And so when you're looking at statistics, sometimes one measure is better than the other. So you can find all three of them, or in this case, two of them, and decide which one is better. So on number four at the bottom, we have some times for the 100 meter dash, and I found the mean and the median for both. Okay, the mean was 12.1 and the median was 11.95. And since this is describing her 100 meter dash times, we're going to want to use the shorter time, which is in this case the median, or 11.95. The last thing you have to do on your note sheet is page 439, problems 32 through 35. Remember that the unit rate is finding out the value per one. That's what unit means, is one. So I've set up proportions for each of these. You don't have to set up the proportions. You can simply divide 1650 divided by 25, 16 divided by 157, and so forth and so on. But you can also use a proportion so that you can find out how much per one unit. Please fill in those answers. And remember that you have three IXL lessons to do for this particular lesson, along with a mean, median, mode, and range BrainPop video. And the homework worksheet is 1 through 10 all.